Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print numbers from 1 to n by using recursion in Python. So I'll be showing you like writing the code at first, and later I'll be explaining you with the whiteboard. So let's get started. So first thing, we need to like define a function that is going to be our recursive function. So it's going to be def, let me name the function as fun, yeah, and let me just now call the function. So fun. So here we will be passing the number n, okay? So that is going to be the solo parameter over here. So first let me give the number n as 7. You can also get the number from the user, that's totally up to you. So in the recursive function, I will just place it as n, okay? So first thing, we need to have a base condition, okay? So in this case, our base condition is going to be, since we are printing numbers from 1 to n, our base condition is going to be, if the number equals 0, we need to like stop this loop, because we are getting n from the user, okay? So this is going to be our breaking condition or base condition. If a number is 0, we are going to break the recursive function, okay? So it's going to be, if number equality 0, just return, okay? This is going to like terminate the recursive function. And we will have else condition as well, because what if the number isn't 0? So if the number is in 0, here we will be like calling the function again, and we will be passing number minus 1, okay? So it will be like kind of hard to understand now, but let me explain you after, like in the whiteboard, it will be like much more easier. So after passing number minus 1, we need to like print, okay? So it's going to be print that particular number, okay? So what happens is that it will get like this, okay? First it comes over here, number comes over here, 7. So 7 isn't equal to 0. It will come to the else part, so then it becomes 6 over here. This particular call gets like stacked in the function stack. I hope you know what is a function stack. So this particular, it gets called, function of 6 called, number becomes 6, and this doesn't print, okay? The print function doesn't go now. So it becomes 6, same thing, it calls 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and after reaching 1, what happens is that it again calls this thing, 1 minus 1 is going to be 0, so it's going to be 0 at the end. So n equal to going to be 0, so this is going to be returned. So after being returned, what happens here is that our n will be 1, and this statement is going to get printed. So if 1 will be, 2 will be, 3, 4, 5 will be printed till 7, okay? So now let me save it and let me like explain you clearly in the whiteboard. Run it, yeah, run module. So here you can see I got the numbers from 1 to 7, yeah, simple. So now let me explain you how this is going to work. So let me first clear this, and let me have it side by side, okay? So first our function value n is 7, so function of 7, okay? Let me just have f of 7, this is going to get called. So yeah, n is equal to 0, yeah, but n is 7, this condition is false, and l, it goes to the else block, and function of n minus 1 gets called. So it's going to be function of n minus 1, n is 7, okay, first call. So it's going to be 7 minus 1, which is going to be 6. So this is like, imagine this as a function stack, okay? So I will like come from the bottom, okay? Yeah, so that it will be like easy, yeah. So function of 7, and it's going to be then f of 6, yeah. So it's going to be a fun of 6 over here. This print statement won't get executed now, okay? That's the only thing. It will get executed when the function calls are getting recalled, okay? So it's going to be function of 6. So n is going to be 6 now. It goes over here. This is obviously false. Else block, fun of n minus 1, which is going to be 6 minus 1, so it's going to be f of 5, okay? And now also this print statement isn't going to get executed. So this will go on till f of 1, okay? Same thing, it's going to be 4, 5 minus 1, 4, it goes again, 4 minus 1, 3, goes again, same thing. No, nothing is getting printed. The output is basically blank right now. So at the end, it's going to be f of 1, okay? At a point, it's going to be f of 1. So it comes over here, function of n is going to be 1, all right? So 1 minus 1 is going to be 0. So at the end, it's going to be f of 0. So our n is going to be 0. It comes here. This condition becomes true finally, okay? And we are having this as a terminating condition, okay? So this will basically return nothing, because we have just returned nothing. Nothing, no value or integer is getting returned over here. So this will like being removed from the function stack. And it will go over here, f of 1, okay? F of 1, what we have left in f of 1? We just have print of f of, print n. That's only we have in function of f of 1. So this will print 1 in the output. Let me have output over here. So this will print 1 in the output. And this will then like be removed from the stack. Then again, it will go to f of 2. Yeah? So this will like, f of 2 also, that nothing has nothing over here. It will then print 2 in the output, which is n. Because n is 2, right? Okay, so this will be removed from the function stack. F of 3, so f of 3 and f of 4 over here. So n is 3, this will be printed, and then 4, and then 5, 6, and 7. So this is how it works. It's basically like all the numbers get, all function calls are getting stacked over each other, and once it like reaches the breaking or terminating condition, that is n equal to 0 return, it just like gets like removed from the function stack. Okay, so and at that point this print statement, well, it gets worked because we have executed the program till this point. Only this line of code is not getting executed for every function call. So that's the reason whenever like a particular function call is removed from the stack, it executes this print statement. Okay, it's like reverse tracking, you know, like it's not directly printing and calling a function. It's like calling the functions and placing it on a stack. And once it reaches a terminating condition, all the statements are going to be printed like one another. So at the end, we'll be getting the output like that. So this is the code. It's pretty much so simple, to be honest. And if you want to print the number from n to 1, it's so simple. Like cut this. Yeah, and cut this and paste it over here. Now if I run it, yeah, we'll be getting number from n to 1. So this is how this works, is that number gets printed and it then goes on the stack. Okay, so that's how it's going to work. If you like, you can just write this on your own. It's simple. Okay, so this is how you do it, and I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.